In this problem, we have a block dropped from rest onto a vertical spring, and we have two different questions to answer. And the first one was intended to be sort of an easy warm-up question. We're getting the speed of the block just before it hits the spring. So that's just a quick free-fall energy conservation type of problem. And then in part B, that's the harder problem. We're finding the maximum compression of the spring. And the main thing that makes this more difficult is actually the math, because we have to use the quadratic formula to solve for the max compression. So starting with part A, getting the speed of this block right before it hits the spring, that's a quick energy conservation problem where we just have gravitational potential energy converting into kinetic energy. And for the analysis there, I'm going to put the origin of the y-coordinate at the tip of the spring. And that means the lowest point of the block has zero gravitational potential energy, and that just simplifies the equation a little bit. So we're going to start by expressing energy conservation here. E initial is equal to E final, and we're going to use that origin where y is equal to zero at the tip of the spring. So if I think about my initial energy, that's all gravitational potential energy because there's no kinetic energy going on. So I'm going to call that mgy initial. And then in the final state, when the block gets to the tip of the spring, all the energy is kinetic. So it's going to be 1/2 mv final squared. So the m's cancel out of this, and we can solve for v final. So we multiply both sides by 2 and square root the result, and we get a final speed of square root 2g y initial. So plugging in the numbers, that's 2 times 9.8 times my initial height of 82 centimeters. I have to express that in meters, so 0.82. And when I run the numbers on this to three significant digits, I get 4.01 meters per second. So now in part B, we want to find the maximum compression of the spring. And the main physical point about the maximum compression is that V is equal to zero there. This is the turning point for the mass. So switching between moving down and moving up, that means it has to be momentarily stationary. And there's basically two different roads we could take, and either way we do this, we're going to end up with the same equation to solve. We could use the result of part A and take the speed right at the tip of the spring and then do an energy conservation analysis. Or we could just go all the way back to the beginning and use the stationary block at a height of 82 centimeters above the tip of the relaxed spring as our initial state. And I would prefer to take that approach of just going back all the way to the beginning, mainly just because we can avoid repeatedly rounding our answers. So what I'm going to do in the energy analysis this time is put zero for the y-coordinate at the lowest point, so at that maximum compression point. And then we state energy conservation again, so E initial is equal to E final. And my initial state is the stationary block 82 centimeters above the tip of the relaxed spring. So it's all gravitational potential energy there. There's no motion in that initial state. But we have to be really careful about the initial y value. I put my origin all the way down here at the maximum compression of the spring. And this means the initial y coordinate of my block at rest is going to be x max plus 82 centimeters. Now in the final state, there's also no kinetic energy because we're at that turning point. And we put the origin of the y coordinate there so we don't have to worry about gravitational potential energy. All we have is the spring potential energy. So 1/2 k x max squared. All right, so now we can plug in some numbers. We have 1.5 kilograms for the mass, 9.8, the approximate value of g, and then being very careful about y initial, that's x max plus 0.82 meters. Okay, and on the right-hand side, we have a 1/2 times k, which is 60, times x max squared. So we end up with a quadratic equation to solve for x max. And the way I'm going to think about this is that I'm gathering all the terms over to the right-hand side, and that's just because it's nice to have a positive a for the quadratic formula. So I end up with 30 x max squared. That's just 1/2 of 60. And then I'm going to take my linear term, 1.5 times 9.8 times x max, and subtract that over to the right-hand side. And this gives me negative 14.7 x max. And then we have our constant term, 1.5 times 9.8 times 0.82, and subtract that over to the right-hand side. And that gives me a negative 12.05. All right, so all of that is equal to zero. And now we can apply the quadratic formula. And so x max is negative b, that's 14.7, plus or minus the square root of b squared, that's 14.7 squared, minus 4 times 30 times negative 12.05. then we have to divide that whole thing by 2 times a, which is 60. So the next thing to do is just simplify that square root part, and then we're going to have to make a decision on which answer we're going to keep here, because this is generating two different results. So this gives me 14.7 plus or minus about 40.8, just doing a little rounding there, divided by 60. So I can see if I keep the plus sign term here, it's going to give me a positive result for x max. If I use the minus sign, it gives me a negative result. So we have to go back and think, like, which one of these is the physical result that we want to keep. And to me, the easiest way to get clarity on this is to look at what that initial y value was for the height of the block when we originally dropped it. We wrote that as x max plus 0.82. In other words, a height greater than 0.82. Well, that means x max is positive. We were thinking of a positive value of x max the way we define things, so that's the solution we're going to keep. So we take 14.7 plus 40.8 and then divide the result by 60. And this gives us about 0.924 meters. And I want to point out that I obtained that number by keeping all the precision in my calculator. If you round along the way, you're probably going to get 0.925. The last thing I want to do here is express this in centimeters. It looks a little nicer, and it's more like the way the information was given to us at the beginning of the problem. So we get a maximum compression of 92.4 centimeters, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.